this Sabbath is called the Sabbath of the month, Shabbat HaChodesh, on the name of the part in the Torah that we are reading this Sabbath in synagogues, which is HaChodesh HaZeh Lachem, Rosh Chodeshim, Rishonu Lachem, which means, as you see in English, this month shall mark for you the beginning of the month, it shall be the first of the month of the year for you. Exodus 12:2. Very important, Sabbath is a renewal. This is what exactly what the rabbi said, that Chodesh in Hebrew is a month, but also Chadash or Chidush is renewal. As if the Midrash said, renew your actions because the head and the first will come against you. Now who is the head and who is the first? As the Midrash says, head is Nebuchadnezzar, Babylon, and first is Esau, Edom, then those enemies of Israel which are threatening to come to fight against, as we see, right, all over history. So this is why we have to renew our deeds, to keep the Torah, to repent. And as the Kabbalists said, Jews got the power to renew themselves, you know, after Holocaust, which could be the end, so they renew themselves, country, new country, new land, coming back. This is the power of Jews, which they got, Chodesh HaZeh Lachem, before. The power of renewal. But the Kabbalah says, if Jews don't keep the Torah, if they don't keep the Sabbath, if they don't use their renewal for Torah, then the enemies, like Hamas today, Iran, look how eager they are, how enthusiastic to wipe out Israel. So therefore, very important Jews should do that. It is only renewal in Torah Mitzvot, and this is a Sabbath, because this Sabbath, from one side for Jews, it is very important, but for the Arabs, it is called land day. Yeah, land day, it is, you know, because they say that Israel took the land from them. They don't believe in God who gave the land to Israel, as the Torah says many times, right? The Torah says, as God said to Abraham, et pritit ishmol.
And this is what the table tells us. So in this table, once in the Torah, you have the full right thing of Shabbat HaChodesh. The Sabbath, you can see in black, Shabbat HaChodesh, the Sabbath of the month. Now, what you have here, which is unbelievable, clearly indicating connection to the Corona. Minimal in the Old Torah, Corona, unbelievable. It means that really this Sabbath can help us perhaps to get rid of the Corona. Israel already is better than others. But amazing is what you have here, parallel, the word Teshuvah. Teshuvah, returning, because returning to God is a principle of everything, yeah? As God says, the Rambam says it, Israel will not be redeemed, Israel will not come unless Jews will do Teshuva. If not, the tractate in Sanhedrin says, 97a, that God will appoint very cruel leader, like Haman in Persia, and today we have Amanai in Iran, exactly the same thing, unbelievable. So it's amazing, we have the Corona, perhaps to remind us. So Shabbat HaChodesh, you see, Black Shabbat HaChodesh, the Sabbath of the month, and you have here also, it is very interesting that the location of this table is to do also with Pesach. It's written here, as you can see in green, Shivat Yamim Matzot Teochlu, 7 days, Masses, and Leben Vred Yishulit, Chag Lashem, Dorotachem. It is a festival for generation. Now what is so interesting here, that you have a sentence, or light is coming, with a redemption. Once in the Torah, this long sentence. Now this fits very much, if you follow on YouTube that the concept of light represent redemption, Torah, Talmud. And this is exactly what we are hoping, you know. And the Sabbath, this Sabbath, is really the beginning and preparing us already for Passover. Passover is the time for Messiah. We will come here also, you have Mashiach here. Messiah coming here. You have another Messiah also. This is Mashiach, son of David and son of Joseph. Yeah, son of Joseph will prepare the way for son of David. It's amazing. And amazing that this Messiah come exactly when you have the sentence, the light is coming of the redemption. So Geulah comes very close to Messiah, because Messiah will bring redemption. What is interesting that we saw here the corona, so merely indicating to us, hoping that really we'll repent, we'll do tshuva. By the way, you have here the word plague, Negev. Mashkit, destroyer. You have a big skip of plague also here, Magefa, in green, but Negev is a Negev, is a plague. Interesting. But clear indication that corona, which is a plague, supposed to bring us to return to God. It is amazing that this is exactly what happened with America, that two-thirds of the Americans says clearly that they believe it is for God. Okay, why God brought it? So we believe, Jews know. All troubles, everything which comes, it is a sign from heaven that you have to repent themselves, to rectify themselves, to return to the Torah, because all these troubles come because of sins. Okay, the two-thirds of the American, very nice, believes it is from God, but they have to believe that there are seven laws of Noah. The most severe one are homosexuality and abortion. Yeah, this was the rain came 40 days, we said, because said, you caused me to destroy, to kill embryo, and 40 days already has something, you know, medically also. So God said, because you caused me to destroy to embryo and fetus of 40 days, I will destroy your world in 40 days. So interesting, God said, I will not bring now, even now, unfortunately, this kind of sins carry on. So God said, no, for this you will not have flood all over the world, you might have flood in different places, tornado and so on. But the Midrash in Song of Songs, homiletic says, before the Messiah, a heavy plague will come. The Hebrew verse is Samuch Limot HaMashiach, next to the days of Messiah, Dever Gadol, great Dever, is pestilence, but is there also any kind of plague? Bala Olam, you come to the world. Perhaps this is exactly the idea, to prepare us to repent, to return to keep the Torah, because without this Messiah cannot come. So amazing, I mean, one should know it, it's very significant. You have small skip of Torah every 2 letters, and very next to it you have the plague, the destroyer. Very interesting. And you have here this year, by the way, yeah? You see Tzapshin, 8 Tzapshin Pe Aleph, 5781. Me'ashpot Yerimim, if you remember, Chatam Sofer, 190 years ago, said clearly, that this year will be better than the previous. Tzapshin Pei said will be difficult, now will be better. No, this may be not. This is what happened with the corona, but if the Jews will do Shiva, it will be much better. So looking more into this table, it is amazing. I said that you have the verse of the Passover, that we have to eat unleavened bread, which is a festival for generation. Now what you should do, also is written here, unbelievable, because see, the letter A of Corona is red. What is this? This is the letter A from the Hebrew word Emunah. You can see it is in red. It's small, it's a big skip, but still it is interesting. Emunah, faith of God, very important. Yeah, our rabbis tell us in the merit of faith, belief in God, Jews came out of Egypt. And in the merit of faith and belief in God, they will come out from this exile of the Islam and Adam. Amazing, no? But unfortunately, the Satan is strong, and you can see what's going on in Israel. Difficult. Still, Lapid and the others promise to desecrate the Sabbath and so on, which is definitely against the Torah, can bring a lot of troubles. So, this is what you have here. So you have Mashiach here. We said you have Mashiach here. And then we have also important thing to get redemption, Messiah. Tefillah, see Tefillah, prayer. So you have prayer, and we have faith, emunah, which is very, very important. And as we said, this here comes here. Also God promised, yeah, he promised, by the way, also Eliyahu, Elijah, because Elijah will come with Messiah together, you know. Yavosh Shiloh. And then, okay, there is a verses which promised, God said, I will guard you, he said to Jacob, to return to the land. When we know everything which happened to our forefathers indicated to our generation. So definitely this promise to Jacob, to God been giving back to his land, to his place, exactly what he said. But now also the promise of Shubne Israel, Nachalat Avotav, that the children of Israel will inherit the land of their forefathers, and all these wonderful blessings, but the most important to tshuva, to return. So very, very interesting and significant table. And as we say, Shabbat HaChodesh, this Sabbath, Shabbat HaChodesh, very important, really, as he needs the power to renew your renewal. Jews, this is the power of Jews, to renew themselves. This is why they are compared to a moon. In Hebrew, Chodesh also is term for the moon, Chodesh. Because the moon has to do with the month, you know. In English, it's very interesting. Moon and month, very close, you see. So the moon also, and the moon is a symbol of Jews. Like the moon, it looks like sometimes all you can see is light in the moon. Sometimes some for Jews are in such a situation, yeah. With the troubles of spiritually darkness, little bit of light, almost nothing. But suddenly people think, oh, the Holocaust is the end of Jews, finish, they will spread all over, no more coming to their land. Uh-huh. Especially the Christians at that time thought they finished. But when we saw clearly when Jews came back, so all the prophecies came out, yeah. The Jews returned to the land. Come back, this is what Donald Trump believed in, and this was evangelists believing, yeah? And this is exactly what is happening. And God said to Jacob, Shmarti, I will guard you, Veshavta, don't worry, you will come back to your land. And here we see, the verse says that Israel will inherit their land of their parents, of their forefathers. So this is the moon, you know, like the moon almost is finished, the thing finished, the end of Jewish people. Suddenly they are growing and growing and they will grow. If not the reform, we'll have 6-7 million Jews more. Because the reform allow assimilation to marry Jews with Gentiles. So when the children, the grandchildren already, they forget they have some Jewish parents. You know, and this is exactly so. But if not the reform, Jews will have now more than 20 million. No, but still, Baruch Hashem, they are growing. It's an interesting and very significant table for our time.